Next up, we have Stephanie Durance. Stephanie attended Herschel from 2012 to 2014. After her school years, she took a gap year in New Zealand, where she spent some time learning about the Maori culture. She is currently attending law school at UCT. She lives at RES and has served in leadership structures in the RES. She has been on the House Committee and a mentor at UCT for the last 2 years. Please give another big welcome to Stephanie Durance.
Good evening to everyone. Thank you to the council and the staff for inviting me to speak. I was here from 2010 to 2014. Yeah. Just to start off, I realized that I was all in pink when I got here, and I'm wearing my pearls. So subconsciously, I was thinking of Herschel. My name is Stephanie Durance. I was born in Cape Town. I grew up in Grassy Park and Retreat. I attended Tymal Primary School before coming to Herschel, and I'm a recipient of the Brendalyn Stemple Scholarship, which allowed me access to a beautiful school like Herschel. I matriculated in 2014, and it's safe to say that the Herschel bubble has definitely popped. My experience at Herschel was nothing short of amazing and terrifying. It was a year where I understood who I was and what I could symbolize in this school. Every Herschel girl is equipped with exceptional preparation for dealing with academics in university. So another confirmation for parents that Herschel is number one. We also come with this built-in function of excelling in everything, not realizing that outside our pristine white walls and hedges, reality is far from excellent than we realize this. Catching up with old girls, and I see Kayla, this is her actually who said this to me. Catching up with old girls is a reminder of this excellence. Kayla actually said to me a few weeks ago, how are you, Steph? Are you doing well as in normal well or not Herschel well? So she wanted me to tell me if I was okay and not, you know? Because being at Herschel, we knew that we had everything crammed into 5 years and all the teachers wanted us to just know everything that we needed to know so we were prepared. So sometimes the standard was a bit unrealistic. So for me, the enrichment weeks we had was a single thing that stood out for me. It was a time for everyone to focus on other aspects of their lives other than academics. Basically, I understood that all the extras that come from being at Herschel supplemented our education so that it stood out from other schools. However, there's always the other side for those girls who don't come from privilege. I heard something along the lines of, privilege is not saying that those who benefit from it don't experience hardships. It's saying that there are some hardships that they will always be exempt from experiencing. For at least 2 years after leaving Herschel, my experiences in university, especially with the Fees Must Fall movements, actually angered me. I was angry for a long time. In this anger, I would think about being at Herschel. I remember days climbing off the bus at the stop in front of the station, petrol station, and like running up and not to be in time for class. And sometimes I'd sweat, and when I get to class, like people would ask me, "Why were you sweating?" And I was like, "It's hot," like, you know. But actually, I was, you know. And so those sorts of moments make you realize that you aren't the same. So when in those moments where I had to hook up to Herschel before I was in boarding, that is, it was like I mentally prepared myself to blend in that was in the bubble that was Herschel. There are many Herschel girls who are burdened with more than the average life load due to structural inequalities that exist here in Herschel and in society. By virtue of the fact that girls like me attend Herschel, we have benefited in some way from these inequalities. We have had access to opportunities that our siblings or cousins or friends will not have or didn't have. And it's this fact that actually hinders us from doing our best. It's not enough to assume that because we are at Herschel, we are in the classroom, that we're all equal. I think that's also what I, you know, started to think of, that, you know, we were all equal in the classroom. Because the reality is that girls of color don't just have to worry about the academics. We can't just shut down in the bubble. We have our families, and we have situations, and we have poverty. And I'm speaking for other girls when I speak about this. I was a boarder at Herschel for the last 2 years of high school. It was there where a fellow boarder shared with me that she worried about her family all the time. She was healthy and well cared for in the walls, but her family was a short distance away and was struggling to make ends meet. And so for her also, obviously, she symbolized what their future could be. During my time as a matric prefect, I asked the matrics to donate anything that they could for those girls in our grade who were struggling to afford things like the matric jersey and the matric dance after party, which for many people are inconsequential and affordable. I think two or three girls at most donated something, which is disappointing considering that we are a school that prides ourselves in helping our community. These are hard things that need to be spoken about at Herschel, and it needs to come from inside the bubble. The transformation starts with the end of ignorance and the beginning of a dialogue that depicts the reality of many students at Herschel. I include myself in this change. I mean, for the longest time, I was scared of embracing my own cultural identity. I was scared of how I sounded. I sat in assemblies, and when colored girls with deep colored accents from the flats spoke, I cringed. I don't know why, maybe because I knew that the idea of a Herschel girl did not come with a colored accent. In saying this, only after I left, I really realized the clear divide in Cape Town after high school. I realized that we excelled at languages like French, but couldn't even do the click when pronouncing isiXhosa. We went to colored and black areas for community service for a few hours, maybe once a term, instead of spending time understanding the lives of the people living in these areas and outside of the Herschel bubble. I speak for many old girls of all colors when I say that I wish we did more work on transforming our minds and social attitudes while still at Herschel. There are Muslim girls and Jewish girls and Hindu girls who are not catered for. There are girls of color and of different sexual orientations that are not catered for. Many girls continue existing in this bubble, and sometimes it seems that it never pops for some girls. But for other girls, when it eventually pops, they are overwhelmed. I've seen old girls leave varsity to take time off because of their mental health, because of the inability to deal with life after Herschel. This is why Herschel is in need of more transformation and inclusivity, so that when students leave school and enter the big world, they are prepared to face a world that is complex, real, and very harsh sometimes. I hope that this perspective will aid Herschel in understanding the way forward towards transformation. Despite what I've told you now, I wouldn't trade my Herschel education for anything. I have actually said to people before the speech that I am very conflicted because I've benefited from my education at Herschel, but I've also understood that there are things that are beyond me and beyond what I can change alone, but I understand that as a collective, the Herschel community, can make things happen. We know that the Herschel community makes things happen when they want to. I've learned many things in the 5 years that I spent here, and I had happy times, or happy days, like Ms. Cochran, I think, used to say. That's just my take on Herschel. Thank you for your time, and enjoy the rest of the evening.